So last year, I did a video with a Fender Mustang short scale bass. And now, I'm not a bassist, I'm a guitarist, so I kind of played it like I was playing a guitar a little bit. Overall, the comments and the response was pretty good. A few interesting ones, of course. But it kind of got me thinking about short scale basses in general. What do bassists really think of them? Do they make you play differently to a regular scale length neck? Are they just for kids? Are they just for beginners? Do they actually sound any different? So hopefully we're going to find out some of those answers. So I did a video about a year ago with a short scale bass. How did you feel, if you've seen it, seeing a guitarist do a bass video? Be honest, be brutal.
I like it. I mean, I think
he's gonna say he likes it. Of course he is.
I think a lot of the times, you know, bass doesn't necessarily get as much credit as it deserves. You know, yeah. A lot of people think of it as, you know, an easier to play guitar. So having someone like you, you know, show off like amazing things that could be done on a bass is cool as well.
I'm trying to, isn't it? Is there a lot of snobbery from bassists towards a short scale bass?
I mean, there probably always has been a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, but I think this year, especially with a lot of the cool options coming out, I think people's minds are starting to turn on them. You know, 2020 has been a year of many things, but it's definitely been the year of the short scale.
Yeah.
A lot more short scales have come out this year. Music Man made one. Sire here made their U5. Sandberg came out with the Lionel. Reverend came out with the Sentinel. So a lot of short scale basses have come out this year.
Do you have a short scale bass?
Do I have one?
Do you have one?
I do not actually own a short scale bass.
Well, interesting, why not?
Well, I'm a pretty big guy. And a lot of the times, you know, short scale basses, people that buy them tend to be smaller, have smaller hands.
Okay.
A lot of advantages to short scale is just obviously the shorter scale. So people with smaller hands are smaller size. It's a little easier for them to play.
So you're telling me big people can't play a short scale bass?
They can, they definitely can.
So what came first, short scale or long scale?
In the world of solid body electrics, believe it or not, it would be the short scale.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So the first solid body electric bass was invented in the 1930s by a guy named Paul Tutmark. He had a music shop in Seattle and he produced them under the name Audiovox, I believe. But they were short scale, they were 30 and a half, and that predates the Fender P bass, you know, by almost 20 years.
Oh, wow.
And then that was one of the things that was really revolutionary about the P bass was that it was long scale.
Yeah, right on cue. That's Paul Tutmark now. Call him.
From the grave. Even through the 50s, the majority of the market was short scales. Gibsons, Hofners, Dan Electros, K. There were all kinds of options in the early 50s, and they were all short scale.
Yeah, because really I was going to say, like, what would be the inspiration to actually extend it?
I would think, and this is just speculation, that the short scale concept was just, you know, a means to an end of making a solid body electric.
Yeah.
And then I think people started to realize the benefits of having a longer scale. Better sustain, you could kind of produce larger sounds, if you want to think of it that way.
Right.
So the whole kind of world of bass players kind of shifted towards long scales. Right.
Do you own a short scale?
I do, actually. You do? Yeah. Which is interesting because, I mean, since I was 9 years old, I've played a P bass. I mean, I've been a long scale player my whole life.
Yeah.
And it's really interesting to see kind of the resurgence of short scale basses in recent times. People are reigniting their love of 50s and 60s kind of sounds. A lot of the newer stuff is kind of nodding back towards a lot of the sounds those guys were getting and evolving them in interesting ways. We'll be right back.
the definitive sound of a short-scaled bass? I mean, if you were to describe
it. I would say that line is a little bit more blurred now with something like that than it is with something like this. You know, mixed the right way, you'd have a hard time telling that from a long scale. At that point, you're getting the brightness. You're getting kind of the same sounds that long scales have gotten for a long time, losing a little bit of the low end and some frequencies, but you really have to look to notice that, I think.
A lot of the times when you're listening to a piece, you know, I don't necessarily be like, oh, well, that's clearly long scale. That one's clearly short scale.
I mean, is that something that I, for example, would be able to notice? Because I can't imagine I would be able to tell the difference.
Right, and I mean, I imagine people that have a more trained ear probably could tell bigger differences, but I think probably for people who maybe don't listen to as much bass solo stuff like that, probably can't tell as much a big a difference.
Yeah, I mean, I'm pretty sure I wouldn't be able to tell the difference, to be quite honest. So 2020, the year of the short scale bass, would you believe? I learned a few different things about short scale bass today. I didn't know there was differences in the sound between short scale and regular scale length. I didn't know that the regular scale length came after the short scale length around the 50s. So that was quite mind blowing, really. So hopefully you get the chance to try them at some point. And also, thanks for watching. We'll be right back.